It's Friday, February 24th, 2017. I'm your host, Sarah Mannell. We have a great show in store for you today. The New Classics Company offer free improv every Friday night at the Geyer Barn. We're going to learn more about the group and get a look at some of the fun improv games during our arts and culture segment. Then, what keeps the Marine and Environmental Affairs Office busy in the winter? Administrative Assistant Debbie Lavoie gives us an inside look. And finally, we'll learn about some new recreation programs this spring with Director of Leisure Services, Patty Machado. All of that on this episode of Barnstable Today. But first, let's go ahead and get a look at today's top headlines. A new $6.5 million carbon treatment system at the Mar Well Field is being proposed. The proposal comes after the town has been purchasing water from Yarmouth at a rate of about $1.25 million a year. Town manager Mark Ells says by looking forward, the town can actually save money.
When we begin to look at putting in place a system with a 20-year life, that you borrow the money and you pay back, the debt service on that borrow is significantly less than what it would cost annually to purchase water from an abutting district. And Yarmouth was great to allow us to connect and have been selling us water at the same rate our end product would cost.
The project would be funded with a bond issue and would be included in the FY18 operating budget. A public hearing on the item will be held during the March 2nd Town Council meeting. Town Clerk Ann Quirk releases this year's election calendar. This year, town councilors in even-numbered precincts will be running for a four-year term. Other seats up for election include two seats on the school committee, two seats on the Barnstable Housing Authority, and the town clerk's position. Interested candidates will be able to pick up nomination papers and get more information about running on June 6th at 6:30 in the Selectmen's Conference Room in Town Hall. For more information on that, you can contact the town clerk's office. The Centerville, Osterville, Marston's Mills Water Department releases its annual report. The report shows no violations of U.S. Environmental Protection Agency standards. The Water Department will be mailing residents a copy of that report. Copies of the report will also be made available at local libraries and post offices. Up next, we're going to learn about the New Classics Company and their improv night for our weekly arts and culture segment. So, Danny, tell me a little bit about improv. I've never actually watched improv.
Well, what we do here is put on an improv show every Friday night for our audiences. And improv, at the heart of it, is really just about conversation. What we're doing right now is kind of improv. It's really, I often tell beginners, it's not going into it thinking that you're going to make a joke every 5 seconds. That's not the right way to go about it. You really just want to keep talking. And as long as you can keep talking and keep saying something, eventually the humor just finds its way into the natural conversation, because improv draws funny people usually.
So that seems really challenging to me. I'm like the news person, so really used to having a script, really used to preparing for interviews, making notes. Is it a tough thing to do when you get in here and get in front of people and start acting?
Well, it can be difficult for first timers, getting over that, oh my God, everyone expects me to be funny. Everyone, you know, if you're not hearing laughter, you're thinking, oh my God, I'm bombing. But that's really, that's not the essence of it. I mean, as long as you just keep the scene flowing, like I said, that humor comes naturally. So getting over that initial, I'm up in front of an audience, they're all watching me, what's gonna happen? That takes some time, but after a couple rounds, you get used to it.
How have you enjoyed? You've been here at the Geyer Barn performing on Friday nights for a while now. How long has that been going on?
I have been personally involved with the company for 2 years now. This will be the New Classic Company's fourth summer in the Geyer Barn. I got involved through improv workshops that we hope to revisit this summer. I came and they were like, hey, why don't you start coming to our rehearsals? And I got involved and eventually took more of a leadership role in helping to run the rehearsals and design shows for performance.
So how does it work? Do you come on a Friday night with a some sort of plan in mind at all? I mean,
yeah.
you're the director, so what are you directing exactly?
Well, on Tuesdays, the group gets together, and that's open to essentially anyone who's interested and wants to play, and we rehearse games. It's interesting to say rehearse because you never get up and do the same thing you've done in rehearsal. It's different every time. And that's part of the challenge on Tuesdays is, you know, we retread a lot of the same ground, but you need to make it new and inventive every time. So we work on just our general improvising skills, and sometimes we practice new games if we want to introduce them into the shows. And then through rehearsals, you know, that brings us to Friday where we all get up here, and I'll come with a list pre-prepared that no one knows about. That's what makes it improv. And that shows the games that we'll play and who will play the games. And they find that out as we announce it to the audience. So we take an audience suggestion and we're off.
Now, what do you hope that the audience takes away from coming to an improv night?
A smile, like a laughter. I mean, that's what we're after. We want to get people interested in our art and what we do. We want to get people interested in this wonderful space. You know, people often say there's nothing to do on Cape, but that's not true. They're just not looking hard enough. We do it here every Friday.
And the greatest thing I think about improv nights is it is free to attend. Anyone can drop by. You do accept donations, though. That goes right back to the company.
Yes, indeed. All of our donations go towards our regular season programming. In the summer, we put on stage shows, stage readings. We host movie screenings on the green. We're very involved and active in workshops and things like that. So,
if someone wants to get involved, maybe find out where you're going to be, when you're going to be, or if they want to come to a Tuesday night improv group, where can they learn more information about you guys?
They should look us up, newclassicscompany.org, and find us on Facebook, New Classics Company. We're looking into maybe doing some workshops to get people more involved so that we can, you know, expand and expand our group. See, that was improv.
Exactly, yeah, exactly. Well, hey, thank you so much, Danny, for joining us and telling us all about this great opportunity for residents to come out and get a few laughs.
Of course,
really appreciate
it. And sorry, man, if you like what you see from this interview, come and check us out Friday nights at 7:30. Like she said, it's free. Our shows are PG-13, so it's fun for everyone involved.
Yeah, thank you so much for telling us all about it. Of course, my guest today, Danny Price, he is the improv director with New Classics Company.
All right, we're going to play a game called 1 to 4, 4 to 1? 1 to 4, 4 to 1. Jamie, Maxon, Matt, Chelsea. Just like that. Now, how this works is we're going to begin this scene with Jamie here. Now, how this works is that Jamie is going to begin his scene. At any point during the scene, I can my hands, at which point Maxie will come into the scene, at which point Matt will come into the scene, and then Chelsea. Now, each person, when they enter, they will bring a brand new scene into the scene. We use that word a lot around here. How this works is that when all four characters are into the scene, they will find their own motivation, or they will be given an impetus to leave from the other players. And they will leave in the reverse order they came. So they will go 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 3, 2, 1. Jamie, you're painting a self-portrait.
Do I look like that? I need a mirror.
Look, Jamie 3000, tell me, I'm beautiful, right?
Yes, you look very beautiful.
Because you can't lie. You're the truth robot. I hope I got the right brand, right? Yes.
I am programmed to shun all falsehoods and speak only what is verifiable.
Yes. So that...
Hey man, what do you think you're doing, huh? What? Huh? You trying to talk to my girl over here?
No! I'm just being friendly.
You don't have to get so defensive. We were just talking,
he
all right?
He was putting his hand out like he was gonna touch your hand, and
I don't like that.
We like casualties like that.
I was just shaking her hand, man. It's nothing. Don't worry about it.
Hey, let me talk to my girl, okay?
Hey, chill out, man.
Johnny. Okay. You gotta stop this. You gotta stop being so territorial all the time.
Okay, I am a...
Ooh, girl, don't you know? Oh, my.
keychain. Okay.
I thought it was my eye.
I sure can't be like
my
eye.
Do we have like a pitch pipe or something? You know what? I'm gonna go make my own territory somewhere else, and you can just stay out of it.
Okay, fine.
So, yes?
Jamie 3000.
Yes. Affirmative.
So, Tim's been texting me. It seems real, right? Like, he wants more than, you know, just a casual thing. Like, he wants more of a relationship.
Let me analyze his vocabulary. He only wants to be your friend. I'm so sorry.
This happens every time!
Hats off to the New Classics Company. What fun does that look like? Amazing improv opportunity. Don't forget that happens every Friday night at the Geyer Barn. The Marine and Environmental Affairs Division considers the winter its busy season. We're going to find out why with Administrative Assistant Debbie Lavoie. To find out what happens at the Marine and Environmental Affairs Division, we have with us today Debbie Lavoie. She is the Administrative Assistant for MEA. Thank you so much for joining us today. We really appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
I want to talk to you about a few things because I think so many people think, what does the Marine and Environmental Affairs Division do in the off season? But for you guys, that's kind of a misnomer. There really is no off season. You're actually pretty busy in the wintertime. What happens at MEA during winter?
Winter time is our busiest time of year. It is unbelievable. People walk in and say, oh, you're so busy, the lines, what are these people doing? Well, to start off with, this is when we renew everything. When you're lying on the beach and you see boats go by and they have mooring stickers on, they didn't get them in June, they got them in January. So we start December mailing out permits, we renew mooring permits, we renew mooring waiting lists, we renew marina waiting lists, then pretty soon we're gonna start mailing out marina slip contracts. We are also very busy right now because the new shellfish permits are out. Your shellfish permit goes until March 1st, but the new ones are already out and people just want to get in and get their new permit. And by the way, Sarah, if you're still going out, there's still oysters. There'll be oysters till the end of March.
That is so good to know. I haven't been because it was a little cold for a few months there. I really hit it up in November, even in December, but glad I want to head back out. So thank you for the tip. Glad to hear that there are still oysters available. We did pass some deadlines for some forms. So already we had, I think, mooring waitlist forms. Those things are done. But there is still a mooring permit.
The mooring permit itself has to be back by February 28th. It has to be completed and sent to the office. The mooring permits, you do get a little bit of a grace period. They give you one more month. You pay a late fee. I think it's a $50 fine. And you still get that 1 month to submit it. But why pay the $50? Bring it in. We're there. And please, if you have any questions about your permits, always feel free to call the office. We will gladly answer your questions. We're there for.
Yeah, and then also another thing that keeps your office busy is, of course, you have animal control services all year round. So if anyone needs help, they call you. That keeps you guys pretty busy, too.
We're very busy with dogs that run loose, dogs that unfortunately bite, but we also get barking dogs. We get... The good thing, and I'll tell you this little story, on Friday there was a dog that had only been in town for a couple of weeks and got out of the owner's, away from the owner. And we spotted it, we knew where it was, I called her, told her where it was, and she said, I've only been here for 2 weeks, I don't even know the street you're telling me. So we sent a couple of officers out, and we were able to rile up the dog and give it back to her. So she was very excited. So sometimes we have good answers to dog issues that are out there.
Yeah, and so important too, I think, if you have any questions, you guys are really the experts, and you're always, you're so kind to answer the phone and help people. You always have great information. So if someone has a question, you guys are the place to call.
Right. We also get wildlife calls too. Fox, coyotes, swans, ducks, you name it, the calls come into our office all the time. If we can't help you at the office, we will direct you to one of the natural resource officers. And the other thing too, leave a message, we will call you back. In fact, it's funny because people will say, you always call me back. And heck, that's my job. I don't mind calling you back at all, answering
right.
your questions.
Yeah, so when a new license is on sale for, it's for shellfishing in general, right?
Mm-hmm.
They don't break it off into different licenses.
The only thing we break off is resident, non-residents, seniors, and those that aren't seniors. But it's all shellfish. Right now, people are getting razor clams. They're getting still the oysters, quahogs. Steamers are a little bit harder to get now, but you know, as it gets warmer, you'll go out there and get some steamers.
Yeah, awesome. If we go out, we can get the permit already for mm-hmm. Shellfishing. How much is the rate this year, the fee this year?
Still the same as last year. It has not gone up. It's $30 if you're over 65, $40 if you're not, and $140 for non-residents.
Wow.
And the only thing we stress, no matter where you go, make sure you read the signs on the street as far as parking. Parking's always a big issue with shellfish licenses. And the fact that you have a shellfish license doesn't guarantee you a place to park.
So make sure you're maintaining rules and regulations when you're parking.
Correct.
Because those parking lots do fill up really fast.
Yep.
Scudder Lane,
mm-hmm.
Definitely a lot of people have to park on the side of the road, so you don't want to make sure you're not blocking someone's driveway.
Yes.
Very important, or you're not blocking another vehicle in as
Absolutely.
Well.
So
Absolutely. Follow the rules of the road there. Good tip.
Which is smart thing anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
And it's not a complicated process. If someone wants to sign up for a shellfish permit, it takes them a couple minutes when they walk in the office.
Bring in your driver's license, and we will give you the permit. We have all the maps. We will gladly tell you where to go. We know a lot of the secret hidden spots that no one knows. We will tell you where they are and what you can get there, and we love to help you. We really, really do.
Yeah, and thank you, because you helped me. I, for the first time, started shellfishing last year, and I'm never going to stop. It's
Good.
One of my favorite things to do. So
yeah.
Thank you very much. You know, hopefully it will stream right into spring and summer before we know it.
Yeah, you better believe it.
Thanks, Debbie. We really appreciate it. Of course, our guest today, Debbie Lavoie. She is the Administrative Assistant at the Marine and Environmental Affairs Division.
Thank you, Sarah.
The Recreation Division has some great new programs to offer this spring. We're going to learn more about those with Director of Leisure Services, Patty Machado. It's just about springtime. I can't believe we're finally saying that. I think I can see it.
The weather kind of shows like it might be, but
yeah.
Not
I'm
for long.
Very excited that we can see the light at the end of the tunnel. And I think one thing that shows me that it's springtime is the program book coming out. This is a
it's
new
my
program book.
Purple.
Yeah, I love it. I love it. So talk to me about, there are some new choices for kids to take recreation classes. What's new this spring?
Well, I know John spoke about a lot of things the last couple of weeks, but the newer programs he didn't get into, and they're not really new programs, we're recycling and trying to see if, they kind of fizzled out and see if there's still interest in getting them off the ground. So the first one is bowling. We're offering bowling and the Ryan Family Amusement. So we pick the kids up at the school and then drive them over to the bowling alley, and then they give a quick lesson, but for the most part we really try to let the kids play on their own and really enjoy themselves and get a lot of laughs out of the whole thing. They will learn some bowling skills. It's not a high pressured thing. It's really low key program. Mickey Davies runs that, and for a while we were averaging quite a few people, and then for some reason we went through a lull for a while, and sometimes when a program goes away and it comes back, it's
almost like people took it for granted.
Yeah.
It went away, and then when it comes back, there's like a renewed interest.
Yeah. And it's funny because we hear a lot of parents going, well, what happened? There used to be bowling. Oh, well,
We'll bring it back.
Yeah.
So we'll see what happens. And then also...
Now, what school is that? Does it come from? Is it Barnstable Intermediate school age, or is that the 4-5?
I'm not 100% sure. It might be both. She's done that in the past. I'll have to look that up. I can't remember the actual ages for that group.
But if anyone's curious, they can look at their books. And this book...
This will force you to look at the book.
Yeah. Yes, this book. Where can we find these books? I mean, these books went home in the kids' backpacks.
Yes.
But other than the kids' backpacks, maybe sometimes kids
Well, we put them in all the libraries. So they're at the libraries. We have them here at Town Hall, and we have them at the Highness Youth and Community Center. Also at the police substations, we put packets. We try and have as many places as possible. So, and we went to the preschools as well. So they went out to, I mean, all. Every preschool that we know of, we dropped them off at. But you can always go online if you need to, if you didn't get one in the mail. Everything's still online, so you can look at it.
One program I'm really excited about is the Lights, Camera, Action program.
Yeah.
And this is, you're teaming up with the Cape Cod Community Media Center for this,
right.
Is that right?
Yes, we did this a long time ago as well, actually when it was on the other side of Yarmouth. Since it's moved to the south side, this will be a whole new location. I think it's even better set up than it was in the past. So we're excited to bring it back. When Sarah left us here. It was funny, she hooked us up with a new person that was running, because it used to be Amy Davies that used to run it for us, and then she's been long gone. So great opportunity to get it started back up, and Michelle Davies is running that again. Again, we'll drive the kids over. They
That's
usually
so
make their own commercial.
For parents.
And,
oh, go ahead.
That's what they do, is they try and we have them make a commercial, and we usually air it on this channel as well as
their
channel.
Oh, I can't
channel.
Wait to see
so
what they come up
So it depends on what
with.
They come up with, right.
So they have great space over there. What an awesome opportunity for kids to get a firsthand experience playing with video and being on air. So really cool experience.
Yeah,
and they have such a great staff over there.
Yeah.
So
yeah, we're excited about having that up again.
And what a great, I didn't mean to interrupt you, but I just
That's
wanted
okay.
to say, it's such a great opportunity for parents where these programs have busing. So it's not like they have to rush
right.
to the school, get their kid, drive to the media center. I mean, it just takes
right.
that away. They will then pick their kids up at the media center at the end of class. Is
Actually,
that right?
we're going to be moving them back to the HYCC because our thought was that it might be too much... the location, actually, the drop-off afterwards back at the Highness Youth and Community Center makes it easy access, we believe,
more
than going down Route 28 to try and get your kids is a little challenging at the end of the day. So we didn't want to add more stress to any families.
That is so. You always are thinking of the parents,
yeah.
and I think that is such a great thing. As a parent with young ones, sometimes it can make or break whether your kid can participate in a program.
Yeah, yeah. That's,
so.
Oh, we try and think through as much as we can to try and make things simple. A program that's not in here, that if you go on the website, we're working on a pilot program, it's exciting, with the Cape Cod YMCA. We'll be offering lifeguard training as a program, as well as junior lifeguarding, and that will be right after school. They have a lull at the YMCA, when our swim team has been there all winter, but 2:30 to 4:30 tends to be a downtime at the Y, so we'll be getting a few lanes, and so we'll be offering a lifeguard training class and a junior lifeguarding class. The idea behind the junior lifeguarding class is we will be offering, if we need more lifeguards, we will be offering another class. So if you're not quite ready to take the lifeguarding class, it's okay. You take the junior lifeguarding class, and we'll prep you, and we'll get your swimming skills down, we'll work on your strokes, we'll get everything ready to take the lifeguarding class.
That is so exciting. Very exciting.
It'll be
It'll be affordable. And, you know, we've been talking about so many times how there's a shortage of lifeguards
right.
across the country. So this is a great way, I think, to help, make more lifeguards for you, make it more affordable for kids, and give them a great profession. Because once you have that, you can make more money as a lifeguard
right.
than, say, working at a clothing boutique.
Right, yes. Yeah. And it's a great summer job to, you know, we have over 100 lifeguards, 105 lifeguards we hire here in the town of Barnstable. Next door, they hire 34. Sandwich High is 15. Mashpee hires. Bottom line is, we're all hurting for getting staff. So Mark Ells has been wonderful support in that, you know, he's driven to help us get kids qualified for work. We'll also be, you know, the Youth Commission is running a job fair come April. So for youth only, it's going to be a youth job
Neat.
Fair, but it's going to be for the whole Cape. So there's a lot of stuff that's coming together, and Mark has a great vision, and our department's very excited to have the opportunity to make his vision happen.
Awesome. That is very exciting. Any idea on the timeline that you might see the pilot program begin with the YMCA?
End of March.
Wow.
Yeah, it's going to go from the March to the middle of May so that they can try out again in June. We'll have another tryout. This only qualifies you to lifeguard. It doesn't say that you're going to get the job. We have, we go through a pretty heavy tryout, and we only hire 14, 15-year-olds as lifeguard aides. So there's still a competition that's going to go on, which is good because, you know, we want the qualified and the best, but, you know, there's still requirements. The YMCA needs lifeguards. Hyannis Resort and Conference Center needs lifeguards.
Cape Codder
needs lifeguards.
And
CBA
some of these
needs lifeguards.
That's right. And some of these positions are year-round.
Yes.
Like the Cape Codder Resort and Spa. They just expanded their facility. So some of the jobs can be year-round. And I'm telling you, it's a great
There's so
skill
much opportunity. And there's, and it's not just in our own town. The towns on the Cape are all hurting for lifeguards as well. And so our hope is that we'll become a mecca and an ability to certify as many lifeguards as possible. I've hired someone to come in from Rhode Island, actually, to run a class in June for lifeguarding. So even if, we're full and we have all our positions filled, that's okay.
Great. Thanks for telling
us
all about it, Patty. We're really excited. And I look forward to chatting with you again in the near future. Our guest today, of course, Director of Leisure Services, Patty Machado.
You can cut.
Now let's find out what's happening around town in today's community calendar. The Sturgis Library is celebrating its 150th anniversary with an open house and birthday party. The library will provide wine, soft drinks, appetizers, and even birthday cake. Staff will also be debuting the Sturgis Community Family Tree and will have exhibits of documents and photographs related to the history of the library. The event will be held Saturday, February 25th from 4 to 6. It is free and open to the public. There are no board committee or commission meetings today. Thanks so much for joining us. We're going to be back Monday with another great show for you. For Barnstable Today, I'm Sarah Mannell.